Hello everyone, my name is Ekat Mukherjee. Just now I have completed my MSc in Agricultural Extension Education. So in this presentation, I am going to tell you regarding empowerment of women in Indian agriculture, that what is the role of women and how they are being treated and what they are doing, what strategies are being made to uplift them. So the path of gender mainstreaming. So gender mainstreaming, basically it means that when gender equality and gender equity are taken together to achieve the objective of gender mainstreaming. So before achieving the objective of gender mainstreaming, these two things, gender equality, where no discrimination or bias is being made, and equity, where the major weakest section or the weakest person are being given the major priority. So now I would like to discuss that in the introduction part, that women are facing a various sort of challenges, a various sort of difficulties. They are being treated as inferior to men, they are being paid very less, unequal wages are being there, and they are not given so much authority or so much rights in any sector regarding, it may be from their household side, it may be in their agricultural sector, in agricultural field. So here it written that the presentation explores the challenges faced by women in Indian agriculture as the strategies are being taken to promote gender equality. So in a call to action statement, we can say, so join us on this empowering journey. In the next slide, I would like to say regarding the gender inequality. So inequality is majorly being seen in the unequal wage payment, in the inequality in every sector, like it may be finance sector, it may be dissemination of knowledge, acquirence of knowledge, or acquiring any sort of assets. So in that case, women are being treated as inferior to men. So we need to break that gap and we need to break that hurdle so that women can overcome their all problems and difficulties and can achieve their success and have a determined mindset in achieving their goals with full attention. So as it is written over here, that Indian agriculture heavily relies on women's contribution. So as we have seen, if I take an example of Darjeeling. So in Darjeeling, there are many tea estates, many tea plants are there. So we have seen that the major hard work and the major drudgery work are being done by women. So they are just cutting the leaves from the tea gardens and just putting in their buckets. So it's a very laborious and hard work kind of a work. So in that, women are being majorly given those kinds of work which are very carrying a drudgery in them. So in that manner, women should be made equal to men in order to overcome all the hurdles they are facing in the agricultural sector. So including the limited access to resources, so they are having very less amount of resources. Discrimination is there in every sort, that as a gender prototype, predetermined mindset they are having, and the unequal pay, as I have already discussed. So addressing these issues is crucial to achieve, and the gender mainstreaming in agriculture should be performed and the objective should be determined to achieve the goal in a shorter time span. In the next slide, I would like to say that in the journey of empowering women or the women farmers in the agricultural sector, so they should be given various sorts of knowledge, various sorts of trainings, various sorts of skills should be taught to them so that they can uplift their standard of living, they can take decisions on their own, they can know what is going on in their world, that what is happening, what schemes are being coming, they can have a good access to the communication system also. So as it is written over here, that empowering women in agriculture requires providing access to land so that they can have a right to land if anything happens in the family, so that women can continue her livelihood with through these sorts of things. Trading facilities should be given to the women, and various sorts of training in any sort of production, like it may be cottage industry skills should be given. Training on mushroom cultivation, because mushroom is a very less investment business startup in relation to agriculture and can generate more amount of profit out of it. So in addition to that, promoting women's leadership and participation. So women should be made participable in every sector, like it may be a non-farm sector or it may be an on-farm sector. So in that process, it is very much essential to give and supply all these facilities to women in achieving the objective of gender equality in the agricultural sector. So in the next slide, the success stories, as we know, many success stories are being there. As if we search Google, there are many success stories we can find regarding women in agriculture, which they have achieved. So highlighting that success stories, we can say that these stories serve as a very powerful agenda, along with a powerful reminder to the society, to the farming community, that women can do anything with their potential and capabilities if they have the determination in their mind. So in the next one, I would say that the government initiative is majorly being taken, that the policymakers are totally sometimes focused on women scheme, women based schemes only. Like we can say, take the example of Kuduma Shri, which was being initiated by the Karnataka government and the Mission Shakti. After that, we can say that the Indian government has implemented various initiatives, so many other schemes are also there. So these initiatives aim just to empower women and just to narrow the gap between the gender in the agricultural sector. So in the conclusion, I would like to say that women should be given equal rights and equal empowerment so that they can have a nicely fruitful future in their coming long run. So in the gender mainstreaming in Indian agriculture is very much crucial, because the Indian people mindset, the Indian people thought thinkings are very different. So they are still now in some way lagging with their religious purposes, with spiritual purposes. So that gaps, those kind of gaps, and the predetermined mindset regarding women, regarding the gender biasness, the gender discrimination should be treated as equal. Any sort of discrimination and biasness should not be made. And lastly, I'd like to say that by empowering women, as we have formulated many strategies, we can enhance the agricultural productivity, reduce poverty, achieve the goal of gender equality, and lastly, we should work together as a group, as a team, to make sustainable agriculture in a very efficient manner for the future generation. So, thank you all. Now, I think that we have got enough knowledge regarding my presentation and what I am trying to convey to you. So, I hope the audience must have liked it. So, thank you.
Most video.